All right, back with the panel. Susan Del Percio, catcher on New York One. I do. Karen Finney. And Matt, do you guys ever go on New York One?
I've not been.
Yeah, but I'd
love to go.
It's a fun thing. Anyway, there are probably people wondering why they're watching MSNBC.
And they could be watching New York One.
That's a very good question. I'll probably get fired. Our specialist today, legal expert and former U.S. attorney Kendall Coffey, our subject, and a fairly obvious one straight ahead in the news. Kendall, thank you for joining us. When I say it's obvious, I am referring to the debate about national security versus the civil court system versus the military court system. What is your perspective specifically on the battle between the Constitution effectively, or how we define our constitutional justice system, and what we're going through and have continued to go through with all this Guantanamo and KSM?
Well, even though the administration had to be politically waterboarded into having these five folks sent to Guantanamo for trials, I think at the end of the day, it may be a political blessing in disguise. It eliminates a lot of the heat they were getting. And at the same time, the attorney general can look at people in the face and say his hands were tied. In fact, there really wasn't much of an option, given the level of congressional resistance, the growing resistance from leadership in New York City. And by the way, military tribunals are constitutional, and the current rules that have been put into effect are much improved over what was originally announced way back in 2001.
Karen.
Well, I guess, but the question is, isn't the actual existence of Guantanamo Bay and this debate suggest that we really need to rethink all of our laws in terms of making sure that our laws and our values are consistent with the way we go after terrorists? I mean, it seems like the initial idea behind Guantanamo was let's get around the law to do what we feel like we need to do, rather than saying we need to make changes.
Kendall, this
was, well,
basically was just done as a workaround.
Yeah, but it wasn't really illegal in the first place. I mean, Guantanamo was badly discredited by some mistakes made early on with respect to conditions, with respect to the processes, which left detainees basically suspended in limbo for years and years without charges ever being brought. The reality is today we now have a situation where we have a unique, distinctive problem. That is, people that say they're making war on the United States, people that are acting outside the rules of law. And the question as to whether you have to try them in a civilian court, I think, has a pretty clear answer. You don't have to. Certainly Eric Holder wanted to. President Obama wanted to. But now that that hasn't been realistically possible, we're going to see trials in Guantanamo that are going to be fundamentally fair. Don't forget that the driver for Osama bin Laden got 5.5 years from a military tribunal. Probably would have gotten 20 in a civilian court. Yeah. And it's probably harder to impose a death sentence in Guantanamo than it is in the state of Florida.
Susan, go ahead.
Just two things. One is, I mean, we say things like not really legal. We talk about muddying the waters. I mean, I think that really does it there when you're talking about what does not really legal mean. And then, again, moving forward,
this was smoking pot.
Not really legal.
Because
okay,
in California, it's kind of legal. Anyway, I'm sorry. Go ahead.
No, and then, and just secondly, is what took, I mean, nothing really changed in the last couple of years for the administration to come to this decision. And the fact that they kind of got here now is, I think, a little bit curious. I mean, they really could have done this a year ago and had and been exactly in the right place
at
the right
question?
Time. I guess what I'm curious about is what real pressure made him, you know, the administration move. You know, we talked about the political pressure that this was good politics. I don't see, you know, why it wasn't good politics a year ago.
Yeah, so why is it good politics now compared to a year ago? And what is the definition of not really legal? And does it apply to, and should I use marijuana in California as a precedent for that?
Well, military tribunals are constitutional and legal. They are. As to why it took this long, I think the administration wanted to send a different message about justice. They viewed Guantanamo and the tribunals as so horribly discredited and such a tarnish on the image of American justice, it would be easier rehabbing the image of Charlie Sheen than the image of Guantanamo. So I think they wanted to get past all that. The reality is they can't. And they're now accepting that as of this past year, when Congress said...
Quickly, Kendall, what's not really legal?
Well, there are a lot of things that are not really legal, but these rules with these safeguards are absolutely constitutional. The biggest question is going to be on the kind of evidence that can be brought into these cases. That may be getting battled out a little more, especially the use of hearsay. But as far as the trials are concerned, fundamentally fair, completely legal if they follow those rules.
Got it, Matt. I promise to get you in next time. Kendall, thank you so much for serving as our specialist this afternoon. Susan, it's lovely to see you. I won't mention where else you can see her. Karen, it's very nice to see you as well. We'll take a momentary break. Straight ahead.